carbon-carbon double bond is there. So that used to generate, that used to treated with bromine, and initially it involved in cyclic bromonium ion formation. Formation of cyclic bromonium ion is possible. But cyclic bromonium ion can be further treated with another bromine. So there is a formation of trans dibromo product. Always bromination is accompanied by transbromination because mechanism proceeded with cyclic bromonium ion. And what we are treating with strong base, that is potassium tertiary butoxide. Potassium tertiary butoxide is a strong base which is used to remove one HBr molecule. Whenever HBr molecule is removed, there is a possibility of double bond and one of the bromo remains on one of the carbon atom. So option number one is a suitable, option number two is not suitable, option number three is also not suitable, where option number four is also, that means one and four having the probability for this compound A. And further, lithium diisopropyl amide will be treated. What's another reagent? Lithium diisopropyl amide. Again, it is a very strong base. Again, it is used to dehydrohalogenation reaction so that the final product will be triple bonded compound. One more HBr will be discarded so that we will get cyclooctane. Being it is an 8-membered ring, we can say cyclooctane will be generated. Now, let us see sequential order of reaction mechanism. Bromination on olefinic double bond proceeded with cyclic bromonium ion intermediate. Cyclic bromonium will be added with another bromide. So, always bromination on the double bond will be trans addition. So here there is a formation of trans dibromo product. This trans dibromo product now treated with potassium tertiary butoxide, right? So what it will do, it will remove HBr. This is called dehydrohalogenation, right? So backside bromo, and here we have one of the hydrogen and the adjacent center HBr will be discarded so that carbon-carbon double bond will be generated. This is compound number A. After this, again, we are treating with another reagent, that is lithium diisopropyl amide. Whenever lithium diisopropyl amide was treated, again, there is an elimination of HBr. We will get carbon-carbon triple bond, right? So now the product will be option number one, where A will be mono dehydrohalogenated one, and B will be 2 times dehydrohalogenated product. So option number one is the suitable answer for this question. And next, let us move on to the question number 97. In the question number 97, you experience bicyclic system having tertiary nitrogen, which is the common heteroatom for contributing to cyclic rings. And here we have one ketonic functional group, and in either side chain ester is there, one of the hydrogen located backside. This is the stereochemical representation of given molecule. Now, whenever this reagent is added, we have to find out what is the probable product upon treating with sodium borohydrogen cyanide. When cyano group is not there, we can say it is NaBH4. Sodium borohydride, it is a mild reducing agent most probably. What kind of groups? Carbonyl functional groups are selectively involved in reduction in the presence of ketone. Here also, we have sodium borohydrogen cyanide. Whenever it is treated, let us see whether ester and carbonyl are only selectively carbonyl group will be reduced. If ester and carbonyl both reduced, you will get compound 1 or compound 2. If only selective reduction of ketone, there is a possibility of compound 3 or compound 4. Now let us move on to its reaction mechanism. Right. So whenever this bicyclic system is treated with mild reducing agent, that is sodium borotrihydrogen cyanide, and we have to maintain the pH of 4, means acidic conditions can be employed in order to convert the reactant into product. Simply, it is the reduction reaction. Sodium borohydride compound is treated on this compound in starting material. Here, being it is the mild reducing agent, it specifically reduces ketone but not ester. Ester will not be reduced. If you are taking any other strong reducing agent called lithium aluminium hydride, then it is possible to reduce this even ester also. But being it is the weak, because boron hydrogen bond is very strong and the removal will not be possible under normal conventional conditions. That's why ketone will be reduced but not affecting ester functional group. So here the formation of OH, which is coming towards the VR, because already ester group is located backside. Being it is a larger molecule, will not come backside again. That's why OH will come front side. So this is called chemoselectivity. Now let us see. The possible product from this one will be option number 3. It is not C. Option number 3 is the right answer for this question, right? Major product formed in this bicyclic system upon treating with weak reducing agent. So chemoselective product formation, that is only option number 3, right? So this is about question number 97. Let us move on to next question called 98, where we are taking open chain molecule having RMGCl kind of nature. When RMGCl was taken, it is a Grignard reagent. This is treated with 60 degree centigrade and ether was added. Everybody know THF is the solvent. THF ether solvent mixture was employed here. Then it is converted into one of the transformed product A, and further it is treated with alpha, beta unsaturated aldehyde. Whenever it treated with alpha, beta unsaturated aldehyde, the major product B will be formed. Let us find out which is the suitable answer for this transformation. So we will start with the starting material, long chain hydrocarbon having 2 double bonds within the molecule and the terminal center having MgCl. So we can assume it is a Grignard reagent. Now this involved in cyclization reaction under 60 degrees temperature condition. When it gets cyclized, the subsequent product will be 5-membered ring with all these side chain. Compound 1 is obtained here. Now, it should be treated with alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde. Whenever alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde was treated among CH2 double bond CHCHO. Here we have double bond, here also double bond is there, but preferential attachment takes place on the carbon rather than double bond, because carbon oxygen bond will be more polarized. That's why here what kind of species generated? Carbene ion generated. It is the nucleophilic reaction, nucleophilic substitution, nucleophilic addition reaction. Nucleophilic addition, this carbene, whenever we are removing MgBr, here carbene will be generated, the selectively attached to the aldehyde group, and subsequent formation of, being it is aldehyde, there is a formation of secondary hydroxy compound will be generated. It will be the product B. Let us see which is satisfying this statement. When ring cyclization, 5-membered ring will be there, and one of the side chain should be double bond but not aldehyde. Side chain should be double bond because selective attack takes place on aldehyde group rather than carbon-carbon double bond. Carbon-carbon double bond will not influence in this reaction. So option number 3 is the correct statement for this problem given in 98 question. Now let us move on to question number 99. In question number 99, we are taking 2 moles of benzaldehyde and treated with sodium cyanide manganese dioxide. right? So benzaldehyde was taken, treated with sodium cyanide. This is a kind of benzoin condensation, named reaction. It is benzoin condensation and subsequent oxidation with MnO2. The formed product will be benzoin, now converted into benzyl. This benzyl can be treated with sodium hydroxide. Actually, here, how many steps are there? Aldehyde to benzoin, benzoin to benzyl, benzyl treated with NaOH, and the final product will be benzylic acid. So in this, we experience two named reactions. One is benzoin condensation reaction. It is the characteristic condensation of aldehydes. And the second is benzyl-benzylic acid rearrangement. The final product will be benzylic acid will be formed. Now, let us see what are the sequential steps and how the mechanism proceeded in order to confirm the product. Let us see. When benzaldehyde was taken and treated with cyano. Cyano, being it is a nucleophile, preferentially attached to the carbonylic carbon. And we will get O minus. This is a kind of cyanohydrin. The product is called a cyanohydrin adductor. The cyanohydrin adductor carbon ion, cyanohydrin adductor having shifting of hydrogen. Proton will be shifted to oxygen and eventually we will get carbon intermediate. This carbon will be attached to another molecule of benzaldehyde because we are taking two moles of benzaldehyde, right? That's why this carbon will be attached to another mole of benzaldehyde. And we will get the product of OH, CN, O minus, H and PH. Now what we will do? We will do proton exchange to another carbon atom. And here this is back polarized and is back polarized towards this side. So here carbon oxygen double bond formation is possible. Being cyano is a better leaving group, it will be eliminated from the reaction. From this, it will be converted into benzoin. Benzoin will be PH, C double bond O, CHOHPH. This is called benzoin, which is obtained by condensation of two moles of benzaldehyde with sodium cyanide. Now, benzoin will be treated with manganese dioxide. Whenever manganese dioxide is treated, being it is an oxidizing agent, here, the secondary hydroxy functional group is there that get converted into ketone. Primary aldehyde, secondary will be into ketone. So we will get adjacent, we can say vicinal dicarbonylic functional groups. Vicinal means adjacent carbonyls, right? So this form is called benzyl. This is called a benzyl. Now, benzyl is treated with sodium hydroxide. This OH minus will be attached to the carbonylic center and subsequent migration of one phenyl ring from one carbon to another so that it is converted into here the formation of C double bond OH. On this terminal, we got carboxylic acid and this carbon we have PH-PH-O-. Further protonation, it is converted into benzylic acid. The final product will be benzylic acid. It is the most important named reactions of, so everybody know, aldehydes and ketones are more prone to involved in condensation type of reactions. We have so many named condensation reactions, including aldol condensation, Cannizzaro condensation, Perkin condensation, benzoin condensation, so many will be there. So this is the most important application oriented chemical reaction of this benzaldehyde. And we can observe the final product in this option number 4. So benzyl, benzylic acid will be formed here. 99 question, option number 4 is the right answer. Now, let us move on to next question. We are going with, this question is the spectroscopy related one, where reaction of styrene. Styrene is nothing but vinyl benzene. The styrene is treated with HBr. Here, this is a kind of addition reaction. Bromo group either attached to first carbon or first carbon are second carbon. So if it is attached to first carbon, monobromo product formation is possible. When it is attached to second carbon, 2-bromostyrene product formation is possible. Now let us see what they are asking for. They are asking for the HNMR spectrum of mixture shows 4 signals, among others 5.17, 3.53, 3.15, 2 ppm with relative integration of 2:1:1:6 respectively. Molar ratio of these compounds should be taken. Whenever 1-bromo and 2-bromo were given, what is the molar ratio we have to find out? In order to get that, here is the reaction. Styrene treated with HBr, the product will be 1-bromo and 2-bromo. Both the possibilities are there. According to given spectroscopic data, 5.17 is given for this carbon, where more deshielding effect will be experienced for this one because it directly linked with bromo and eventually with the phenyl. So in both the cases, electronegative nature will be more. That's why this carbon is experiencing high deshielding. That's why downfield shift can be observed for this carbon atom. Okay. And next, when you consider the CH3, which is away from all electronegative groups, so it is upfield. Here, shielding effect will be there. Upfield shift can be observed. That's why 2.0 will be given for this methyl. When we are taking these two methylene groups, both are experiencing electronegativity groups. This carbon directly linked to bromine, and this carbon also directly linked with phenol. Phenol, always phenyl group will be electron withdrawing. So that's the reason why both are experiencing the shielding effect, and both are almost similar. 3.15 for one proton, 3.53 for another methylene group will be given. This is about the proton NMR spectroscopic values of brominated products. Now, what we have to do, the molar ratio of AB should be how extent this product will be formed, how extent this product will be formed. That molar ratio we have to find out. Let us assume it is formed in 1 mole, it is formed in 4 moles, because most probably bromo group in organic chemistry, bromo group will be specifically attached to the carbon where more stabilized carbocation is there. Here, the carbocation being it is the primary, stability will be less whenever this secondary carbocation was taken compared to this one, stability will be higher for this 2-bromo. That's why 2-bromo will be the major product. So we are assuming 1-bromo is formed in 1 mole, 2-bromo is formed in 4 moles. Okay. Now let us see the what peak intensity ratio. Let us find out peak intensity ratio. 1 mole of CH2 protons are there. How many protons? 1 into 2 protons are there at this methylene. Plus, here also 1 molar we are taking. That's why 1 into 2 protons can be considered here. Here also you can consider 1 into 2 protons. Means 2 protons will be there. Peak intensity will be 2:2 here. Now, let us move on to the second compound where we have CH. Means 1 proton is there. How many moles it is formed? 4 moles formed. That's why we can say 4 into. It should be 1, not 4, sorry. So, 4 into 1 proton will be there where it is. Let us assume 1 mole, 4 moles. Here it is. Here. 4 into 1. 4 moles of 1 proton will be there here. So, 4 into 1 it will be. And also, here 4 moles of this methyl will be there. How many protons? 4 moles of 3 protons will be there. Now, intensity ratio will be here 1 mole of 2 protons. Here we are not supposed to indicate plus because this is the intensity ratio, right? 1 mole of 2 protons for this methylene. 1 mole of 2 protons for this second methylene. 1 mole of 2 protons for second methylene. 4 moles of 1 proton here. then 4 moles of 3 protons are there. This is not required. Again, we have to take intensity ratio. Ratio will be considered here. Now, it will be 2 is to 2, 4 is to 12. 2 is to 2, 4 is to 12. When we are taking this, so it can be simplified further. So we can take in, we can convert into 1 is to 1 is to 2 is to 6. Intensity ratio will be 1 is to 1 is to 2 is to 6 will be taken. Now, let us see whether it is matching with our compound or not. In the given problem, 2 is to 1 is to 1 is to 6 ratio is given, which exactly matching with the ratio what we are obtained here. The ratio, in this, whatever ratio obtained, that exactly matching with this problem. Hence, we can say, right. So this 1 is to 1 is to 2 is to 6 is matching with this one. That's why we can say the ratio between A and B compound will be 4 is to 1, because we are not getting exact same ratio, but we can say the ratio is matching. So one of the compound is in 4. Series 4 in this CSIR Chemical Science 2019 set A paper. So hope it will be helpful to you. Thank you. Thank you very much.